The history of paleontology is rife with strange and intriguing alternate versions of animals we now take for granted. Whether it's the arm flippers of Bedar's Compsognathus, the hulking shoulder humps of McLaughlin's Ceratopsians, or the sprawling gait of Tornier's Diplodocus, these unorthodox hypotheses of how to reconstruct what we find in the ground usually stem from logical misunderstandings of the fossils at hand. One of the most famous set of arms in the history of dinosaurs belongs to Dinochirus. They've remained a mysterious set of disembodied nose pickers for over 60 years until two relatively complete skeletons were uncovered in the late 2010s, blowing open the doors of what an ostrich dinosaur could be. The second most famous set of arms in the history of dinosaurs, on the other hand, belongs to Therizinosaurus. Hopefully you'll recognize the name Therizinosaurus and immediately attach a strange and oddly goose-like picture to it. It's the largest member of a group of theropod dinosaurs adapted for scrubbing through vegetation with its probable long neck, beaked snout, and definite elongate arms and claws. For the longest time, Therizinosaurus was a completely enigmatic beast defying description. It's now known as the largest member of its own group, a strange family of sloth-like animals with pot bellies and long necks used for gracefully stripping plants of their leaves and snapping up small animals. The Therizinosaurids are most notable for their long arms capped with three long claws, the use of which has been debated for decades. The general appearance of Therizinosaurus remains unknown, forcing paleontologists to extrapolate from other close relatives, like Nothornicus and Bapiosaurus. However, as strange as you might think it looks, how it was originally reconstructed is far stranger. The bird-like remains of what would eventually go on to be called Therizinosaurus chelaniformis were found in much the same way as many of the other fossils of Mongolia have been found, that is, as just one discovery amongst many, during expeditions by entire teams and science departments to remote sections of the globe to help further scientific knowledge all in one go. Many institutions have undergone these ventures throughout recent history, most notably the Central Asiatic expeditions of the 1920s by the American Museum of Natural History, led by Roy Chapman Andrews, and the Polish-Mongolian paleontological expeditions of the 1960s, helmed by Zofia Kielan-Jaworowska. Therizinosaurus remains were found as part of the Polish-Mongolian paleontological expeditions by folks from the USSR Academy of Sciences in 1918, and the very fragmentary remains were subsequently described in 1954. Prolific Soviet paleontologist Evgeny Maleev named and described these remains. He is perhaps most well known for his naming, description, and research of Tarbosaurus. He was one of the first to take a look at dinosaur brains by cutting into the skulls of exceptionally well-preserved Tarbosauruses, a process now refined to computer tomography scans and 3D printing. The holotype consisted of a set of claws, some phalanges, pieces of the wrists, and some ribs. Maleev thought this animal was something truly unique, a new group of animals no one had ever seen before. He was right on the money, but the wrong currency. The ribs associated with Therizinosaurus were incredibly long and flat. The wrist was expansive and suggestive of an incredible musculature. The claws at the end of the hands were elongate, flat, and tall in cross-section. All of these characteristics did not say to Maleev that this animal was a bipedal, tree-munching sloth bird. How could it? No, the remains suggested to him a giant, ocean-going turtle, the likes of which the world has never seen. From his own words,
"The massive metacarpal bone and the giant ungual phalanges show that the derived forelimb is nearly transformed into powerful swimming organs. The forelimb has long, grooved, sickle-like ungules, concluding in a tip with a keratinous sheath. They may have been originally used by the animal for cutting aquatic vegetation, or for another function, constrained by movement and acquiring food.
He compared the flatness, dimensions, and proportions of the ribs to those of the giant Cretaceous sea turtles, Archelon and Protostega. This would mean Therizinosaurus was the largest turtle to ever live, many meters wider than the Cretaceous sea turtles. This reconstruction shows an animal without a hard shell, much like the leatherback sea turtles of today. He gave it a new group name, the Therizinosauridae, to hold its unusualness. Maleev writes, "The family is characterized by a broad, compressed body, with barely developed or almost completely absent body armor, presumably due to the very fragmentary and very few pieces of broad ribs. With the connection between these ribs and lack of armor to the ribs and lack of armor of turtles, he must have assumed it had a whole body similar to turtles too. He also calls the forelimbs nearly derived, with trenchant and huge claws, despite not having fossils of the majority of the forelimbs, again going off the assumption the scythe lizard is a turtle." How did he get it so wrong? Since this was the first incidence of these animals known, how could he have figured it would be what we now know it to be? At the time, claws like Therizinosaurus's had never been seen on terrestrial animals. The only living or extinct animals with claws like Therizinosaurids were turtles. Many freshwater terrapins carry a set of nails, which would make even the most flamboyant hairdresser swoon. Some of these little reptiles use their claws in courtship displays by playfully slapping their mate-to-be across the face. They also use these claws for holding food or pinning down prey. Meanwhile, snapping turtles use large recurved claws for securing themselves on the bottoms of rivers and lakes. Tortoises, as the outlier, have extremely blunt, fat claws for supporting their immense weight. Archelon, Protostega, leatherback sea turtles, and any other sea turtle for that matter, don't have the keratin-tipped sides of Therizinosaurus, which is odd since Maleev considered them somewhat similar. I have a sneaking suspicion Maleev was more convinced of a testudine identity from the ribs and fit the claws into that identity, since freshwater terrapins and soft-shelled turtles have long claws too, though they weren't as long as a turtle Xenosaurus would have. When Therizinosaurus was alive, Mongolia was nowhere near as dry as it is today. In fact, there were lush rainforests dotting the sand dunes with rivers and streams lazily snaking their way across the lands, many of which were connected to the oceans. There were even beaches at the time. This suggested to Maleev that there was plenty of suitable environment for such an animal at home in the water. There's a big problem with the use of the set of ribs as one of the main characteristics of a testudine identity. They belonged neither to Therizinosaurus nor a turtle. These enormous ribs come from a sauropod. Sauropod ribs are big and flat, just like the ribs of a turtle. I find it strange that a comparison wasn't made to the leatherback sea turtle, since its shell has no supporting bony structures other than their ribs. It's just a big wide rib cage and would have fit the isolated ribs a lot better than the more complex shells of Archelon-type turtles. Later finds of other theropod dinosaurs would go to show these remains were far from the turtle side of the reptilian tree. The 1990s and early 2000s saw the discovery of animals like Segnosaurus, Bapiosaurus, and Nothornicus, all of which had huge burly arms tipped in Freddy Krueger claws. The ribs, long since shown to be of sauropod origin, were thrown out of the holotype specimen for good. Further finds attributed to Therizinosaurus would include a pair of relatively complete forearms, with another set of meter-long claws, leg and foot bones, as well as more traditionally theropod-shaped ribs. And yet, the exact shape of Therizinosaurus remains unknown. What we do have of the beast is that it was related to forms that share the general characteristics of long neck, wide guts, long arms and claws, big splayed feet, short tails, and beaked and toothed skulls. Therizinosaurus's biggest claim to fame now is that it's still the largest of this group to ever be found, possibly measuring as much as 9 meters or 35 feet in length. More than capable of defending itself from any hungry tyrannosaurs, tenacious enough to attempt to secure such a powerful animal. The sands of time have not been kind to the remains of these animals, and our understanding of them will continue to be revised. But as for Malayev's Therizinosaurus, it has been thoroughly shown to be a forgotten misfit in the pursuit and advancement of scientific knowledge. I want to give a special thanks to Sombraptor. He voiced Evgeny Malayev's quote. I recommend checking out his channel of the same name, where you'll find Star Wars and dinosaur content. Make sure you like this video and share it around. Leave a comment if you like and subscribe. Hit the bell icon too if you want to stay in the know with everything Edge. Thanks for watching. Pledge to my Patreon at any tier you like for a slew of many delicious offerings. Special thanks to patrons Dinosaur, Natty Cat, Steve Bradshaw, Thea Svensson, Arda Bayer, Ray M., Dana Manchester, Aphid, Kirby, and Chris Frampton.